Cargo hold of a ship is an important area as it carries the cargo, which allows the ship owners to make a profit from the ship. A clean cargo hold from an efficient cargo hold cleaning operation makes it possible for the ship's crew to carry the designated cargo. It is important for ships such as tankers, bulk carriers to have an efficient cargo hold cleaning operation procedure. Bulk carrier ship contributes approximately 70 to 20% of the global merchant fleet, carrying different types of cargoes in bulk. A ship can carry different types and grades of bulk cargo in the same hold after the cargo hold is cleaned properly. Hence, the efficiency and cargo carrying property of any bulk carrier largely depends on an efficient cargo hold cleaning operation. In this video, we will understand the cargo hold cleaning procedure of bulk carrier ship. The method for cargo hold cleaning will depend on the type of cargo which was carried previously. If it was a dirty cargo such as coal, sulfur, or products which may react with another cargo, the tanks need to be cleaned thoroughly with chemicals and water. Care needs to be taken for not using water if the cargo has a tendency to react with it. Some cargo such as cement, coal, etc. needs to be shoveled first. Once the hold is empty, such cargo will leave a thin layer on the cargo hold surface which needs to be cleaned by use of chemicals. Once the chemical cleaning is done, the hold is washed with seawater. For clean cargo such as grains, corns, etc., the hold can be directly washed using seawater without the use of chemicals. The preparation for cargo hold cleaning starts during the voyage at sea. Toolbox meeting should be conducted and the chief officer must brief the crew about the type of cargo, type of chemical to be used if the cargo is dirty, amount of chemical to be used, etc., along with all the safety equipment and personal protective equipments to be used. The main decks should be washed before arrival to avoid cargo debris from the main deck being carried into the accommodation and freshly washed cargo holds. The crew selected for the cleaning operation must be well trained and know all the aspects of risks involved, such as slip, trip, fall from height, chemical exposure, etc. Prepare the machinery, safety equipments, and important personal protective equipments needed for cargo hold cleaning. The chief officer must ensure there is sufficient fresh water available on board and shortlist a tank from which the fresh water will be used to wash the hold. The plan must include but is not limited to the following: the extent of washing required, removal of bulk cargo residues, hand washing requirements, cleaning of the cargo hold bilge, identity of blanks to be opened or closed. Hold washing operations are often carried out in the anchor with the vessel's hatch covers open. The bulk carrier ships can carry different types of cargo which require different hold cleaning method. However, the basic of hold cleaning always remains the same. It is important that the cargo hold must always be cleaned to the highest standards possible, regardless of the next commodity to be carried. Hence, the master and the chief officer must have an approved cargo hold cleaning plan. The first step is to clean the topmost area of the cargo hold, which is the hatch covers. The hatch combings are also cleaned using compressed air and brush to remove any debris and cargo deposit. even a small amount of dust or previous cargo residue underside the hatch can contaminate the whole cargo during the closing of the hatch. The drain channels of the hatch cover to be cleaned off for any cargo residue, scale, corrosion, and dust, as they are usually inaccessible once the hold cover is shut. The drains should be cleaned and checked for any hindrance, as during rains, a choked drain may lead to water overflow into the cargo hold. Similar attention is to be given to the hold access and ventilation hatches. If the hold still contains cargo which the crane or grab was not able to remove, the crew should scrap it using shovels. The next step is to clean the sides or the walls of the hold. For this, the ship's crew need to lower the scaffolding, other tools such as shovels, hydroblaster, chemicals, etc. into the cargo hold. The crew can use portable ladder to reach the higher areas and underside regions of the hold. The cleaning needs to be done from top to bottom. Height safety or fall prevention arrangements are prepared by the ship's crew, and the same should be checked by the chief officer before starting the operation. In this video, food grain standard for cleaning the cargo hold is explained, as it is one of the most used one around the world. The inside and underside of the hatch combing in the hold is cleaned first using brush, brooms and scrapers to remove the stuck deposits from the hold walls, followed by spraying seawater using fire hoses to remove loose debris from the surface. This is done first to ensure the debris does not fall into the freshly washed hold. The scraping of cargo stuck to the wall is continued from top to bottom, and seawater is constantly sprayed to clear the loose debris. Once the scraping is done, brushing of the wall is carried out along with water wash to remove the dark patches from the wall, which can be due to prolonged cargo accommodation. The side shell frames and end brackets needs to be checked for pockets of accumulated debris, and they should be cleaned thoroughly. In case of any visible loose paint flakes, paint blisters or loose rust scale, it should be removed using a scraping tool. The hold is then cleaned with fresh water. If needed, detergent is mixed with the fresh water to get better cleaning of the hold surface. Some cargoes such as bauxite, sulfur, manganese ore, etc., if carried, needs chemical cleaning. Usually the chemical is sprayed using an air pump connected to a lance pipe. A pre-wash coating can be applied using the same washing gear to ensure chemical does not affect the paint surface and structure of the hold. Once the chief officer checks the cargo hold and decides no more scraping or chemical wash is required and all residues have been removed, the holds and hatch covers are then rinsed using fresh water to remove any dried salt attached with the hold structure. The degree of freshwater rinse or wash also depends on the nature of the next cargo to be loaded. If the cargo to be loaded is steel, it is important to remove all chlorides in the hold, as any sweating may produce salt water which could affect the steel. The cargo hold is then thoroughly air dried to ensure there is no moisture and odor in the hold. If the cargo carried previously requires more stringent cleaning, that is hospital standard cleaning, the hold is checked for any peel off the surface for paint, and crew will repaint the area followed with a barrier coat and dry it off for the inspection. The cargo hold bilges and filters are then cleaned for any residue. When disposing both cargo residues and wash water, ensure that the requirement of MARPOL Annex 5 are strictly followed. MARPOL 7378 Annex 5 requires that all ships of 400 gross tonnage and above have an approved garbage management plan and a garbage record book, and the cargo residues are treated as garbage. Cargo residues that remain on board after discharge are thus included in the definition of garbage and need to be disposed of outside special areas and as far away from the nearest land as mandated by this MARPOL regulation. If the cargo residues stinks, it is to be discharged outside 12 miles. And if the cargo residue floats, it is to be discharged outside 25 miles. The garbage management plan should include minimization of cargo residue washed down water and its discharge. Any cargo residue and washed down water disposal or discharges should be recorded as garbage category 4 in the garbage record book, and the entries should include start and stop positions.